Hello and welcome. I'm Linda Kincaid. Ahead on CNN Newsroom, an exclusive look at Russia's sprawling network of fortified defenses, showing what Ukrainian troops are facing as their counteroffensive inches forward. Hong Kong still being battered with high winds and heavy rain as Typhoon Siola moves to the southwest and Typhoon Haikui has its eye on Taiwan. And India prepares to launch its latest space mission, this time to study the sun.
Live from CNN Center, this is CNN Newsroom with Linda Kincaid.
And we begin in Crimea, where Russia says it's foiled three attacks on a vital bridge in the past few hours. Russia's Ministry of Defense claims it destroyed three Ukrainian sea drones loaded with explosives launched at the Crimean Bridge, also known as the Kerch Bridge. It links the annexed Crimean Peninsula to the Russian mainland. It's come under attack many times since the war began, as it's a critical lifeline for Russian forces. Ukraine hasn't yet commented on that attack. And after months of delay, Moscow now says its newest nuclear weapons system is operational. The Sarmat system is an intercontinental ballistic missile capable of delivering multiple nuclear warheads. It has a range of 18,000 kilometers. That's far enough to reach the continental United States. And on the battlefield, Ukraine's military says they have penetrated Russian defenses in the Zaporizhia region in the country's southeast, but they're being hammered by Russian trenches and barriers on the front lines. CNN's Melissa Bell reports.
The scars of war. Russia's sprawling network of fortified defenses, including the infamous Dragon's Teeth, clamping into Ukrainian ground. These pictures, shot by Ukraine's security service and shared exclusively with CNN, a reminder of all that lies before Kyiv's advancing troops. The counteroffensives gained so far, slow but steady.
We are not failing. We are moving forward. We liberated thousands of square kilometers of our land through minefields with no air coverage.
The Ukrainian military says it's consolidating positions on the southern front lines and looking to the next layer of Russian defenses, with the country's foreign minister reassuring impatient allies.
Our partners who are helping us, including the United States, they understand that things are moving in the right direction, and they understand that there is no tragedy or no kind of slowdown.
Meanwhile, Russia renewing nuclear fears. The country's space agency announcing that it's put the Sarmat intercontinental ballistic missile on combat alert. As attacks on Russian soil increase, drone strikes, once shocking, now routine. Moscow's mayor announcing on Friday the foiling of yet another attack by Ukrainian drones on the capital as well as surrounding regions. Russia's defense ministry spokesperson also praising Russia's air defenses.
281 Ukrainian uncrewed aerial vehicles were destroyed, including one Tu-141 Strij jet, as well as 29 Ukrainian aircraft-type UAVs in the western regions of the Russian Federation.
But some drones did get through this week. These new satellite images show the damaged planes at the Kresty airbase in Russia's western Pskov region. An attack launched from inside Russia, according to Kyiv. The burned remains of the aircrafts, Russia's own scars of war. Melissa Bell, CNN, Ukraine.
Ukrainian children started the new school year on Friday. This is the third academic year disrupted by the war. Many parents prepared their children with two backpacks, one for school supplies and another for the bomb shelter. Ukraine has invested heavily in making schools safer and building shelters. The government says about 84% of schools are now equipped with bunkers, now a requirement for any school that wants to bring students back to the classrooms. UNICEF reports many children are falling behind in their schooling and struggle with mental health issues because of the war.